I think you're live.
Yeah, you are.
Hi, bonjour monde. It's 5:02 Central Time. It's happy hour. Let's have a drink. Do you have a drink, Dee Dee?
Yep, I got a drink. Butternut needs a drink.
Ah. Thank y'all for showing up, those of you who might be there, for the X number of entries into the David Doucet's COVID Courtyard concerts.
Hard to say.
Which are now inside because it's too damn hot.
Whoa, is it hot out there?
Summer has arrived in New Orleans. It's 108 degree heat index out there. And it's been another rough week of, you know, not necessarily good news in the world.
Hey, Pocasad, you got, oh man, that meal from Bryson's last night. Amazing. Hey, Charles, how is it in Alexandria? Hot, I bet. Speaking of which, do you ever go speak? See, he probably goes to Kisatchi, maybe.
He might. Okay. Ask him.
I am right now. JC's here with requests, my man.
I got your requests, JC. I don't know if I put one of them in there, but I know there's one in there. And I'll talk about that when I get there. Let's see. Once again, we have to do the usual. Thank you to WWOZ and WWOZ.org. I don't remember what it is. WWOZ Radio for putting all these, for advertising all this, or at least listing all the concerts. Once again, with all the craziness out there in the world, there are no venues for musicians to play at in the world, apparently. So we're all doing it from home. Or wherever you can. I appreciate that y'all are all there. And there on the screen somewhere is the tip bucket from PayPal and Venmo, as well as we have it written out here. I don't know if you can see that, but we did low tech up here. And a day when you had 1,700 cases in Louisiana, things are not leveling out like they wanted, which is really sad. We're doing our best. We wear our masks, we wash our hands, and we stay as much far apart from people as possible, like we're supposed to. Other than that, it's just hot.
However, once you have to like confront the demon sperm all by yourself.
Oh God, we're not even going. I thought I was going to save that till later about the demon
Remy
sperm.
Remy Doucet suggested demon semen, which is much better than demon sperm in my opinion. It's just Pocasad floating around his backyard pool with margaritas.
That sounds good.
It does sound good.
Well. In that case, let's get started here. Thank y'all for tuning in. I got some interesting songs here today. I hope I get to them. I hope I play them well. We start off with the state song, You Are My Sunshine. Y'all can sing along. Y'all should all know it by now. I think this is 19 times I've done this. Who's counting?
Who's counting?
Me happy when skies are gray. You never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. The other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamt I held you in my arms. When I awoke, dear, I was mistaken. I hung my head and I cried. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine. and make you happy. If you will only say the same, but if you leave me to love another, you will regret it all some old day. You're my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
Louisiana State song. You might find it interesting that the demon sperm lady used to practice in Alexandria. So there's a Louisiana connection to the wackiest of the wacky for this week in America. I know.
Can't say much to that.
Whatever made her leave, Charles?
Jesus.
Angela Keller checked in from Chicagoland, and also there's a big thunderstorm in central Louisiana, so it's not as hot. But honey, it's so hot down here. You just walk into the mailbox, put you down. Wish we were in that backyard pool floating around with Poco and Michelle.
I know, man. We need that backyard pool.
I know. Well, you'd have to have a backyard too.
We got a backyard, just ain't got no pool in it. All right. So I do have a couple of requests, but I'd like to get these out of the way. The ones that I was thinking of.
Do we have a theme this week?
No, we got a theme.
So we're gonna call this hodgepodge, like on Jeopardy.
But I have semi-theme because
you have a semi-theme?
Someone put on Facebook that it's been 25 years since Can Ray Fontenot passed away.
And no.
Can Ray was quite a person. He was a force to reckon with.
I can't believe it's been that long.
He's been a hell of a fiddle player. A really great friend to... he was a lot of fun to hang around with. And if you don't know who Can Ray is, you know... Google him so you can see what he looks like, because he had an infectious smile, and he was a really great musician. And like I said once before, on a trip that my brother could not make because of an emergency kidney stone, Can Ray came along, and he definitely was the tonic to an otherwise boring trip. He was quite a character. So this is one of his songs. We'll start a little fast song first. I played this once or twice before. It's called Be La Manche. It's a song about an old boy who steals sheep to impress widows. I guess in agrarian civilizations and places, that really has a lot of weight. I've been told that this song, or at least the melody...
I think it sounds very attractive.
It is. It's very attractive. And maybe... Some of these...
It'd work on me.
Some of these melodies and words and all that have to do with... came from Normandy. That's what some people think. Normandy in France, not Normandy, Louisiana. There is no Normandy. I don't know if that's true or not, but I was told that by someone who was from Normandy many years ago.
So it's probably a place where stealing sheep would impress someone. Anyway, rest in peace, Can Ray.
25 years.
I know. That's hard to believe.
One quick story about Can Ray. So in 1986, we were invited to play at Carnegie Recital Hall in New York City for the World Music Organization. It's run by a guy named Robert Browning. And, you know, those were the days of low budge, and there was no hotels. We stayed at people's houses, and Can Ray was with us on that trip. And as well as the complete Beausoleil with Errol Verrett and Tommy Como, believe it or not, it was a bunch of us. And I'll never forget, we played about three or four gigs, but the big one, of course, was playing at Carnegie Recital Hall. And when we got out of the car, the cab, or wherever we got to, whatever the street it's on or the side of it, I'll never forget, Canary looked out and says, "Oh, I played there before." I will never forget that as long as I live. And he looked at me and says, "I'll be back in a minute, David. I know where the liquor store is." And so he ran off to go get a half pint or something. So it was quite a trip playing at Carnegie Hall with Canary Fontenot, believe me. So here we go. Be La Mange.
Yes, indeed.
By Canary Fontenot. It's a cool too. Very weird little songs. Okay, so that leads to his other song that he played. Every time he played, he always did this next song. Mm. And this one is called Les Bars de la Prison, the prison bars. It was a song, I think, that was written by someone named Douglas Belair. And he wrote it from jail because he was condemned to jail. And if you're real lucky and you're really good at YouTube, you can find the original version of this. He's playing it with somebody. And the most interesting thing about it is they're both playing the same song, but one's on the accordion, the other one's on a fiddle, and they're playing in different keys. It's pretty close to noise. But it's the same words. So Can Ray would always play this.
Questions
coming.
Just raise your hand. Where's your sister?
I haven't heard from my sister since she went to Lafayette.
Nah, that's not true. She said the traffic was terrible on Cali Saloon or something.
Always is, Paulette, if you don't.
JC's off to the beach, and he also wants to remind you that it was 1986. You guys were at Night Stage in Cambridge, Mass. That must have been... Does that sound about right?
Oh, yeah. Can Ray was there, too. Night Stage, I remember I was working and got there late and took a cab there. God, that was a long time ago. Anyway, that's a lot of water on
that. That was a long time ago. I mean, that's like a long time ago.
Everything was a long
time
ago.
That's cool you got to go to the ocean, though. Man, it's beginning to be a little bit, getting a little claustrophobic here. In the city that Care forgot.
Come on, little guitar. So this one's called The Prison Bars. It's a song about a guy who's condemned to prison for the rest of his life, and he's pretty much come to terms with it. His mother's not very happy about it. She's on her hands and knees and she's crying, and he tells her in the last verse, he says, "Look, Mom, don't cry for me anymore. Don't cry for your child anymore, because it's better to try to save, you can't save my soul. Try to save your own, because I'm going to go to the Flamme d'Enfer, which is the gates of hell."
That's so sad.
Yes, it is. Well,
while you're getting that, guess who just checked in from Bozeman?
Who?
Ed and Janet. You see him at the con.
Oh, thank you.
he's a little distracted from the week's activities, everybody.
Everybody's distracted.
I know. Is this not working a number on everybody's short-term memory?
Thank you. des mains sur la tête en pleurant moi, elle dit oh. Cher petit garçon, tu vas jamais avoir à ce que tu condamnais pour la balance de tes jours dans les par la prison. Je dis ma chère,
practicing it.
Gotta practice.
That's a sad song though.
It's extremely sad. That's why we're gonna do a happy one after this. This one's
I agree, Angela. I think it's a good I think he does a great job with that. Puppy just knocked the sorry about that, y'all.
It didn't have an earthquake.
Yeah, no earthquakes in
Mudquake
New Orleans.
In New Orleans.
Yeah.
We're gonna play a happy song from the Hackberry Ramblers. The Hackleberry Ramblers, what we call them. Two songs. This one's for Ben Samuel. I know he's not listening, but this is for Ben because he also requested the one after this. And I take requests seriously. Might not play them, but I take them seriously.
Might not know them.
This one is called, this was like their opening theme song. They did this all the way to the days that they died. It was called In Piazza Si e In Piazza Laba. Got a dollar here and a dollar there. It's spelled Piastro, if you want to know, In Piazza Si. The Hackberry Ramblers, next to Beausoleil, was the longest group that ever performed in all of country music. They started
country
in...
Country music, Cajun?
Country and Cajun, but any kind of music, because nobody... They started in the
somehow
early 30s.
This can't be.
And Lutheran Darbon was the leader of that band. And they were famous for certain things. And number one, Lutheran played fiddle, but he also taught himself music so he could read music. And so he taught the guys some standards that were playing on the radio, you know, 1932, 33, 34. But they were famous for some other things. And one of the things they were famous for, and not just playing 65 or 70 years together, was that they were the first band to have a PA system. And they would run it off of their Model T. You know, you'd park it far away from the stage because you didn't want to hear that, you know, and they had a little generator. They would run it so they could run an amplifier. So they were the first amplified Cajun band, or at least that's what Lutheran used to say. I don't know if that's true or not. But he was joined by his pal Ed, what was Ed's last name? Doggone it. Edmund Duyon. Who left the band several years because he went to help dig the Panama Canal, he said.
Which is what we all say. Every time we disappear for a few months, we say, I just went to dig the Panama Canal.
He had some psychosexual problems. He was kind of an odd guy, but I loved Ed. He was a great guy.
We don't know if it was psycho. We just know it was sexual.
I'll never forget that jazz fest.
Yeah, so interesting toys.
And the band band continuously played until they all just really just died. The last time I saw Lutheran was in 2005, late 2005, early 2006. We had played a show, Beausoleil played a show in Westlake, Louisiana, next to Lake Charles, the other side of the bridge, on the Texas side of the bridge. And Lutheran came out, he had his cane, and the last time I saw it, one other little tiny story about them, I'd gotten their number, or his number, from my brother Michael, and I wanted them to come play at the World's Fair, because everyone at the World's Fair thought they were all, you know, deceased. And I said, no, they're still alive. So I called up Lutheran, and he had this very Texas accent, hello. And I said, I told him who I was and all that. And so we were friends for the rest of our lives for that, because I hired them. He said, we're getting kind of tired playing the nursing home circuit. So he looked forward to playing at the World's Fair. And you know, they played festivals across the United States. They were nominated for a Grammy the same year that we won one. There were three groups that were nominated for Grammys in 1997. That was the Hackberry Ramblers, Joël Saunier, and Beausoleil. The other two had not been nominated 14 times before that, so they gave it to us that year. We earned it that year. But Lutheran never seemed mad. He loved it and was very happy that he was out not playing in nursing homes anymore, because it was getting a little harsh. And I don't think he ever went to the nursing home.
Sean Bertrand just said that they used that PA the first time in Pine Island, 4 miles from where he lives. I gotta tell you, people, there's a Cajun music story for every square inch of South Louisiana, just about.
It's nice to know I didn't make that one up. Anyway, this is a song.
There's your contest.
What's true?
Exactly. What's David saying?
Well, I got a couple of others coming up pretty soon. I did have a little theme today, but I'm not giving it out. So here we go with In Piasici e in Piaslava. J'ai eu 21 ans, ma femme m'a dit c'était le temps. Le temps j'arrête de dépenser une pièce ici, une pièce là-bas. Ça va être une pièce ici, une pièce là-bas. Ça va être une pièce ici, une pièce là-bas. Place ici et place là-bas. It's a nice little song.
About hackleberries.
The hackles, yes.
The hackles.
All right, so I decided to play this other one. Ben Samuel had requested. This is one from the songs I learned from playing Beausoleil from Edius Nakin, who was a fiddle player and a songster from a town called Redell, Louisiana, just north of Mamou. And this song is about a guy who thinks he's a very good cook, but he even makes bananas taste bad. That's how bad of a cook he is. And he calls it the hack on Moreau. Why are you shaking your head over there?
Huh?
You're shaking your head.
No, I'm thinking about how bad bananas would taste. It's terrible. It's a horrible thought.
I agree. Here we go. There's a line in there. He says, he's going to make a fricasse, a chicken fricasse, but it's inedible. And he's got this little cart with candies on it, and he knocks it over in the dust, the poussière, that's how you say dust. And it tickles him so much that he laughs and laughs, so he becomes a bon bocheur, a happy drunk, as opposed to a mean and unhappy drunk. So our boy Moreau is a happy drunk. Le lac à Moreau, la capotée dans la poussière, les bananes sont pas mangeables, le candy a tombé, et l'été pour sourire, allons danser Moreau, n'y amuse pas quand même, allons danser Moreau, les jours les plus chers, allons danser Moreau, pour manger des bananes. Gâteur de ménage. On a été chez Moreau hier soir, cher. Elle nous a fait ton fricassé, il n'y a pas mangeant. Allons dans chez Moreau, mes jolies pluies, cher. Allons dans chez Moreau pour manger des bananes. Chez lui, c'est le rack à Moreau, ça capoté, cher, capoté dans la poussière. Les bananes sont pas mangeables, allons dans chez Moreau, mais tous les pêcheurs, allons dans chez Moreau pour manger des bananes. Thank you.
Yeah.
It's a good tune.
Yes, it is.
Played in a truly, what would you call that? Hawaiian style.
All right. Bonjour, Smith.
All right,
bienvenue. So, what do you want to do?
I need to play. I have a request for the Midland two-step, and to that I'm going to add the Balfa Brothers, the Balfa Waltz. But I need to do a couple of other weird songs. Originally, we thought we were going to do drunkard songs today. So let me do the
Midland.
Wait. That's what we talked about last week, but I don't know if that.
Oh. Okay.
But we didn't.
It looks like Smith is like gutting birds out on St. Charles Avenue.
What do you mean?
Like that. Like dead birds.
Why?
I don't know.
Oh, he's gone hunting. Has he gone hunting on St. Charles Avenue in New Orleans?
Yeah, done clean a duck in full view of the street. Lord, child looks like murder over there. Wow, Charles Ward, we're so happy to have your kitty Zora with us. We have good friends, Shelly and John. John's a musician, Shelly is a wonder. And they had a cat that just passed yesterday named Zora. So your Zora is the new Zora. So we're happy to meet her. So yeah. And yeah, Smith, stop cleaning them ducks. It's not duck season, is it?
No.
Well, he must be pigeons or something.
It's never pigeon season. This one is a song that I recorded as solo in my 1957 album. It's very hard to get the rhythm of Amadeo Arduino, but it's called the Midland Two-Step. And years and years ago, I can't remember, this was early 2000s, I was invited to be a teacher at the Balfa camp, and it was the last year they had it at Lake Foss Point, just to the east of St. Martinville, but in the basin, in the swamp. And someone made a video of me playing this song, and I hadn't played it for a while. So if you looked up my name on Google, for many, many years, it still might be this way, this is the song that I'm playing. Let's see if I can figure out some words to it. That's not the right ones I just picked right there. I know that. Let's see. It's a song that Midland Two-Step is one that apparently years and years ago also that this German film crew happened to hear Beausoleil play it. And they made this film around Errol Verrett. He was our accordion player at the time. And Errol's big goal in life was to be able to get off the all rig so he could play with Beausoleil full time. And I'll never forget this. This is my first year in grad school.
Errol was on the rigs? I thought Errol was in the crawfish cleaning plant.
No, but he was. But in the movie, in the film,
he
was a chain thrower on the character. His big goal in life was to play accordion with Beausoleil. And it was really weird because everyone was in the midst of growing beards and facial hair. And at the end of the show, I didn't have a beard, but at the beginning I did. And it was like, really, but in the middle I didn't. It was so weird. But because of this song, we got asked to play in Germany in 1983. We started off in Germany and played in Cologne, right there in front of that big cathedral that the Allies use as a target how to get to Berlin or whatever. So here we go. So if you want to play guitar, this is a tuning that I use out of a modified G. I capo up with a five-string capo and play a C position. It ends up being the key of D. Wahine Cajun style. Tu m'as fait tant la misère, tu t'as jamais fait à rien. quelque part. Et pour me faire honte, mais pas honte, mais veut pas dire. Oh, ya, ya, ça peut passer. Tu sais que la manière qu'on est comme. So let's see. Charles wanted, not Charles, JC wants the baffle waltz. Okay, we'll do that. Gotta play these requests. This is a song that I learned from listening to the Baffle Brothers, their family tune. It's a song about an old boy. He's got, decides to go visit his girlfriend unannounced and finds her in the arms of another guy. So I think. Wasn't feeling so good after that, was he? So here we go. Hello, Butternut. What you doing? You being a pill?
Mm-hmm.
Why you being a pill? Sit down. Sit. Sit.
You think she has food for me?
I have no food.
You watch out, you'll end up like Smith's duck.
The Baffle Waltz. Quand j'ai parti de la maison, j'avais fait mon idée. J'étais parti pour chercher pour mourir au bout de mon sang. J'arrivais à ta maison, j'en ai trouvé une autre avec toi. Mais ça, ça casse à mon cœur, cher, j'aime mieux mourir que boire ça. Tu le sais que j'adore ma vie. J'entendrai toi dans les cerfs pour passer les deux autres avec toi. J'aime mieux mourir dans tes bras.
Showed up to say hi.
Hello,
which is
Paulette.
Great.
Hello, Paulette. Long time no see.
Yeah.
I'll have a drink.
Wish we could come over and say hi.
We will. Someday, we will. All right, so let me get tuned up. You know, I'm going to play the Drunkard's Blues. I don't feel like doing that one. Well, maybe. Ooh, time marches on. Let's tune up, and I'm going to play one that I've been working on. Maybe you heard this. This is one that we recorded, mostly recorded twice. One Michael sang it just as a cappella, and then one that we did on a live album we did at the turn of the century. 20th to the 21st.
20, 21st, 21, 22, 2018.
Where's Becky Smith?
Random numbers.
Well, I remember with some of these things we did.
Well, that's good.
Some of them.
I can't remember any of them.
This one is called... it's one of the Lomax collection, and... this was a song that was Alan Lomax recorded, two very drunk guys singing. We get Un Marié, Un Ouvrier from that, I Married a Carpenter. This is one that my friend Jean Bertrand really likes. And like I said, we've recorded it, Beausoleil's recorded it twice. Alan Lomax found these two guys, and I have the note here from Jean, on a Sunday in 1934. Lannes, Vincent, and Sidney Richard borrowed their uncle's mule to supposedly go to church in Kaplan, Louisiana. Instead, they ended up getting drunk and recording six songs in a rice mill for Alan Lomax and the Library of Congress. So this one is called, we call it La Ma Douce Amie, but it's also called Took a Mistress, J'aime pas une maîtresse. It's a song about a poor boy who falls in love with a rich girl, and of course the parents aren't having any of it. In the end, he asked to borrow a pair of scissors so he can cut the ties that bind them and a handkerchief to wipe away his tears.
Man, you're playing some sad songs today.
Well, I'm in a sad mood.
Poor guy, man. Whatever happened to earning rich parents?
Song don't say.
Uh-huh, I didn't think so. Never does.
You know, most of these songs about things like that, the girl dies.
Oh, man. It gets even worse.
Broken hearts and stuff like that.
Wow. Still in awe, getting drunk in a rice mill in the afternoon, singing songs with your mule.
When you're supposed to be at church.
Church. Uh-huh. That's some classic logic there. Nobody will ever know.
To me, this one... in a way, is as close to, if you listen to Sonny Chillingsworth, who's one of my favorite Hawaiian players, well, he talks about the lava song, and he talks about a cowboy on the Parker Ranch, the largest ranch of the highest whatever, in Hawaii, and they have lava tubes all over the big island. The guy falls in the lava tube, and the whole song is about the guy trying to get out of the lava tube, and that's what the end of the song, he says, and you know, folks, at the end of the day, we all try to pull ourselves up, and keep on going. So that's in the way this one, we're going to cut the ties that bind. It's an odd connection, I admit.
Edward Hess says they're actually cheering him up, so things must be.
Hi. J'ai fait une maîtresse, toi jour il y a pas longtemps. J'ai fait une maîtresse, toi jour il y a pas longtemps. J'ai de la voile dimanche aussitôt le lendemain. Ça serait pour demander, c'est la sujet d'être refusé. Bonsoir, bonsoir, mon père. Votre fille en mariage. Bonsoir, bonsoir, mon père. Votre fille en mariage. Non, non, ma fille, elle est riche et de mille en mille. Ça serait un garçon de rien qui gaspillerait tout son bien. Je parais à partir. Ma douce amie, prêtez-moi vos beaux mouchoirs. Mamie, ma douce amie, prêtez-moi vos beaux mouchoirs. Ça serait pour essuyer les larmes qui coulent. Ça serait pour dire à Dieu que je suis paré.
Comment on the wine rack is, it looks like we've gone through some wine this week. So I'm not sure how with three bottles.
We bought some of the ice box. Oh. Martin Wine Cellar was closed this week because of who knows. COVID.
We don't know why. Yeah, it was because, yeah, so we didn't get to make our usual wine run. I guess you're right, Paul. It does look a little empty.
We'll take donations. There's a PayPal account and a Venmo. Yeah, those. The top one is a Beausoleil wine we got from playing at the City Winery in New York. The one below that or the one on top is Bobby Hebert wine.
I think it's Bobby Hebert is.
Or it could be Drew Brees. I think it's
A Drew Brees bottle that someone gave us that just sits up there and collects dust. Basically.
It just collects dust like wine bottles are supposed to. That's I'll never forget. Tote. Port. That was Michelle Robert wanted some port one day. That's been there for probably,
five years.
You don't even want to know how long, maybe longer. I probably should throw that one
away. Really, it's just the bottom five that we drink every week. But we do get through those bottom five every week. guess, and there's some champagne in the ice box if this thing ever ends. But we may just crack it open before.
All right. So let's see. What did I want to do here? I'm looking to see if there's anything I missed.
Is there a Cajun opera? Has anybody written a Cajun opera?
I don't think so.
You don't think so?
Maybe I should move to the American sector. I was going to play another Huckleberry song or Austin Peay song or Boudreaux, which takes forever. And there's also Wednesday afternoon. That was with Gina Forsythe, but I'm going to wait for that one. Yeah, let's do a... Let's change it all up. How do you like that? That's minor. You don't need that. This one's for Charles Ward. I was listening to this, and people ask for this stuff all the time, and I don't do it. And, you know, not because I don't want to. For some reason, I don't get a lot of time to practice. Usually, I do on Thursday nights. I practice a few tunes and get used to it. But this, the weirdest thing about this lockdown business is that we seem to be busier than ever. And our
you
time,
seem to be busier.
Our time is filled up differently. Our days are different because... You know, it's the longest stretch that I've never left home to go play music or go anywhere, for that matter. Not even a trip to Florida or whatever. So it's like the days really, it's like...
One long
Groundhog Day. It's all the same. So...
Wait, what are you talking about? I forgot already.
Well, not leave. Here you go. So anyway, I don't get to practice as much as I want.
Oh, okay.
Everybody's out there climbing on the trees now, swinging in the breeze now, hanging on the vine. I'm a dreaming about a sailboat. I don't need a fur coat. Underneath the dashboard, got some sweet potato wine. I can see your back porch if I close my eyes now. I can hear the train tracks through the laundry on the line. I'm thinking it's your business, but you don't got to answer. I'm knocking on your screen door in the summertime. Knocking on your screen door in the summertime.
Wow, you have a debut. That's the first time.
I did it once before.
You did?
Yes.
Are you sure?
The week that John Prine died, I did that, yes.
Okay.
I did. I remember. That is it's a song by John Prine called Knocking on Your Screen Door from his last CD, I believe.
I don't know. It's the first time I ever heard it was just this spring, so before he died. I was on Nick's show, Nick's radio
That's
show.
That's right. He told me about it. I said, David, I have a song I want you to sing.
I said, David, I think you can play this song.
So there you go. So it talked.
So Charles said, thanks for that. A lot of people requested it since he died.
I know.
But it's like Jeff has, but he is not here today. So you can just keep getting better at it. I think it was a tape, you know.
Okay, but I have it on tape. That's all right.
Oh, all right. Okay.
I didn't do a very good job the first time. Oh, so. I didn't even say what it was called. I just played it.
That's probably why I don't remember it. You can play Summertime. You can play songs that have summer in them. Singing an opera.
Summertime, and the living is easy. Catfish are jumping, and the cotton is high. Your daddy's rich, and your mama's good looking. Hush, little baby. Honey, don't cry. One of these mornings, you're gonna rise up singing. Gonna spread out your wings and take to the sky. Until that day, summertime, and the living is so easy. Catfish are jumping, and the cotton is high. Your daddy's rich, and your mama's so good looking. Hush, little baby. Honey, don't you cry. Hush, little baby, don't you cry. Two summer songs.
Very, very nice.
All right. That's a good one. I don't know if my friend Doug is out there. I've been thinking about him. Doug, you out there today? I have a friend, childhood friend, his name Doug, and he has this, he's a jewelry maker now, and his studio is called Slide and Delta Studios. And you can look him up on Facebook for Slide and Delta, and he's there. Sliding, S-L-I-D-I-N.
He makes a handmade silver jewelry, and it's definitely worth going by and looking if you're trying to find some gifts. Because, you know, Jeff Bezos doesn't need any more money, right? So, shop local. Artful,
shop local. Shop, well, shop Louisiana.
Shop Louisiana. There you go.
So this is one that kind of grew up listening to John Hurt playing this one. It's called The Sliding Delta. That slide delta George sliding Delta, you're on right by my door. I'm leaving here, baby, don't you want to go? I'm leaving here, baby, don't you want to go? I'm going up the country, ain't coming back no more. I'm going up the country, I ain't coming back no more. That sliding Delta, run right by my door. Sliding Delta, run right by my door. Suitcases packed, my trunk's already gone. Oh, tell me, baby, what in the world you waiting on? Oh, suitcases packed, my trunk's already gone. Oh, tell me, baby, what in the world you waiting on? That big old Kate Allen, she got ways just like a man. She gonna steal your baby any old time she lands. That sliding Delta, run right by my door. Sliding Delta, run right by my door. Sliding Delta. I like that song. That big old Kate Allen, she's got ways just like a man. All right, here's another John Hurt song. No one requested this one, but you know, when I was learning how to play guitar and did a little research, you know, at the library at USL and got some more records, people always said that Candyman was John Hurt's most requested song because when they heard it, they couldn't figure out how he did it. And so never seeing an obstacle that's, you know, gonna stop me, I have to figure out how to play this song. And to tell you the truth, it's been so long since I've actually listened to the album, I'll probably play it a lot differently than John Hurt. But this is a very interesting song. It's quite sexual in nature. like a lot of his tunes. The Candyman, you know, he's got a lot of, you know.
That's, you got yourself a PhD dissertation there. You got the sexual nature of
true
Delta blues, you think?
In his 1929 or 1928 version of this, I believe he capoed on the third fret, second or third fret. I can't really tell you, so I don't really know. So, thank you, Ed. Appreciate that. So here we go. The Candyman, which isn't the same as Reverend Gary Davis's version. There was a friend of mine who moved to Lafayette. He wasn't a friend then, but I met him in Lafayette. And he had gone to Stephen Grossman's school and learned how to play with Stephen Grossman. If you know who that is, he's a guitar teacher and recorded a lot and played a lot. And his version was, Gary Davis's version is not the same as this one. So this is Mississippi John Hurt's version of the Candyman. Sweet, oh yeah. Well, you must be stuck on the Candyman stick, oh yeah. Mighty sweet, oh yeah. Well, you must be stuck on the Candyman stick, oh yeah. Thank you. smart song to play. Mm-hmm. It's a relief, by the way, if you want to know. When you play it up here, you get to rest your arm muscles up here, believe it or not.
So that's the song that you were saying is sexual in nature?
Yes, he's got a stick of candy 9 inch long, sells it fast, how I can chew his corn. He'll stick a stick of candy in your hand. All I can hear is Sister Joan said, she always takes a candy stick to bed. Tell me.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
Maybe it's not. Maybe he's... only know what I've read.
Ah, I see.
John Hurt was a very weird one. This is one. I actually have a version of him playing an Ernest Tubbs song, believe it or not. Walking the Floor Over You, and it's so bizarre, his style. So this particular song, he mimicked, or he thought about Jimmy Rogers' song and put it together in the inimitable John Hurt style, and he called it Let the Mermaids Flirt With Me. Do not work for pleasure, earthly peace I'll see no more. The only reason I work at all is to drive the wolf from my door. When my earthly trials are over, cast my body out in the sea. Save all the undertaker bills, let the mermaids flirt with me. My wife controls our happy home, a sweetheart I cannot find. The only thing I can call my own is a troubled and a worried mind. When my earthly trials are over, cast my body out in the sea. Grab all the undertaker bills, let the mermaids flirt with me. Darling has forsaken me. If I ever see her face again, I'll have to swim all far across the sea. When my earthly trials are over, carry my body out to the sea. Save all the undertaker bills, let the mermaids flirt with me. Blues all on the ocean, blues all in the air. Can't stay here no longer, I have no steamship fare. When my earthly trials are over, cast my body out in the sea. Save all the undertaker bills, let the mermaids flirt with me. Save all the undertaker bills, and let the mermaids flirt with me.
It sounds more like a singing brakeman. It sounds like
it's a Jimmy Rogers type song, yes.
Instead of, what's his name? Yeah, well, you want some cognac?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm not sure I think it's all right.
I got it.
All right, so this leads me to one that I was doing, and last night Dee Dee said this one sounded pretty good. Let's see if I can do it. Did I play harmonica on this? That's what I can't remember.
Dude, I was up there drowned in Irish grammar.
Erin Gilbraith.
Oh.
I'm not gonna tell you the name of this one. I hope y'all figure it out.
Is on every Saturday, just like normal. You did know that?
They got no crowd in there, but yeah, it's on.
No, I mean, I know nobody's there. But I mean, it's on some strange streaming device that apparently people can't find. Like, they're looking for it, but they can't find it. It's called Circle. I think it's called Circle. But anyway, tomorrow night, I think it's the same. It's Vince Gill, and it's Emmy Lou, and it's Rodney Crowell. from our neck of the woods with the possibly the best Christmas album. It's this time of year is always about Christmas songs in New Orleans, believe it or not. We have Christmas shows. And there's some really good Christmas records out there in country music land. We should do a Christmas show.
Well, when we'll still be doing this at Christmas time.
No, I know.
Oh, sorry,
no.
We can do a Christmas show. We will. It's a Townes Van Zandt song. Kind of fits the same thing. We said Emmy Lou, it all works out since she recorded it. Everybody recorded the song. Doc Watson recorded it. My version is based on his. Townes Van Zandt, an amazingly strange man who wrote some really great songs. If I needed you, would you come to me? Would you come to me and ease my pain? If you needed me, I would come to you. I'd swim the seas far to ease your pain. Oh, the night's forlorn, every morning's born. And the morning shines with the light of love. You will miss the sunrise if you close your eyes. And that would break my heart in two. If I needed you, would you come to me? Would you come to me, love, and ease my pain? If you needed me, I would come to you. I'd swim the seas far to ease your pain. She's with me now, since I showed her how to lay her lily hand in mine. Surely you will agree, she's a pretty sight to see, and a treasure indeed for a man to find. If I needed you, would you come to me? Would you come to me, love, and ease my pain? If you needed me, I would come to you. I'd swim the seas for to ease your pain. Yes, I'd swim the seas for to ease your pain.
Very nice.
That's a cool tune.
Yes, it is.
And listen to that one for a long, long time.
Yeah, a little town, Destrehan. Destrehan. That's a great Christmas song.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, that's Benny Grinch and the whatever. Grinches, the Yats, the whatever. 12 Yats of Christmas.
The 12 Yats of Christmas.
Oh, my God, a little town, Destrehan.
All right, let's see if I can do this one. Otherwise, I won't do it. No, for some reason, the words are not popping up, so I'm not going to mess with that. So, sucks. Doug's dude sitting out there?
He is. He's right here.
Doug, this one's for you.
Yeah.
You know, what do I got in here? I want another one. Gonna cheat and not play cross harp on this. Growing up, my brother brought home a record of a group called Martin Bogan and Armstrong, And they were a great string band through the late 70s, 80s, and early 90s. I was able to tour with Michael, with Howard Armstrong. We did two or three tours with him. Quite a character. And he had just finished some sort of opera or some sort of play that was based on him called Louie Bluey. And Howard was quite a force to reckon with. He was 94 years old and he did this fiddle tour. It was awesome. Never complained, loved playing music. But this is one of the songs that they're not the easiest band to work out because it's a band, you know, and everyone's playing a lot of different stuff and all that. And by the way, the cognac is awesome. Thank you.
That's that weird cognac from La Rochelle.
Good day. So this is, I've worked out some other ones, but this one popped up in my rotation today. So this is for you, Doug. Oh, little Mamie, run to the window. Oh, little Mamie, run to the window. Oh, little Mamie, run to the window. See me fall, see me fall. I've been falling from my shoulder. I've been falling from my shoulder. I've been falling from my shoulder till I'm down, get on down. This old hammer is most too heavy. This old hammer is most too heavy. This old hammer is most too heavy. For my size, for my size. This was my favorite verse because it took me about 20 years to figure out what he was actually saying. The captain got a bulldog and he weighed 500. Well, the captain got a bulldog, and he weighed 500. The captain got a bulldog, and it weighed 500. In his backyard, his backyard. You know, before I knew anything about dogs, I thought he said a pull dog. Ted Bogan song. All right, I've never played that one. I don't think you ever heard me do that. Ever.
Yeah, that was good. We were going to do the one about the party, too.
That's one right. That's right. I'm going to save that one for next week. That's right. Let's give a party. Give
yeah.
it right here. I bring the whiskey. You bring the beer.
Yeah.
Oh, me. Oh, my. Oh, you. Oh, you. Susie. That one I have to figure out how to play three parts at once and get Didi to sing the other part. So there you go. Not hard at all.
That's a great song, though.
This is one from Doc. That, you know, I never used to listen to it because it was always too dramatic. But the older I got, I was intrigued by it. I can't play it like him. I don't know what kind of finger-picking thing that he did. But Tony Rice did this, and he did it in like a 6-8 time. It was really cool, and I can't play 6-8 time for, you know, for squats. So I have to do it my way. Doc said that he did learn it from out of a John Lomax book of cowboy songs. I was going to play Along the Navajo Trail, but I didn't got the words out, so this is going to take its place. This is a song about a cowboy that his days are just about over and he's got some worries. This kind of ties into the Bars La Prison, except he's not in prison. This guy's already, he's dying, man. He's like, he's so much dead that he's not even alive anymore.
Oh, that's so sad.
Songs are sad today, y'all. Called the St. James Hospital. Early. Oh, that's not the right key. No wonder that sounded funny. Aha, it's a little low for me. God, come on.
Doug thinks he did say bulldog.
It's hard to tell, but it's a bulldog, I think. A bulldog.
Well, Buttermilk could be a bulldog.
It's true. Early one morning at the St. James Hospital. Early one morning, born in the month of May. When I looked through the window and I spied a dear cowboy. Dear cowboy, as cold as the clay. Set ye down by me and hear my sad story. Set ye down by me and sing me a song. For my poor head is aching and my sad heart is breaking. I'm a poor cowboy that knowed he done wrong. Send for that doctor to come and heal up my body. Send for that preacher to come and pray for my soul. For my poor head is aching and my sad heart is breaking. I'm a poor cowboy and hell is my door. Get 16 pretty maidens to come and carry my coffin. 16 pretty maidens to come and sing me a song. And tell them to bring some of them sweet smelling roses, so they can't smell me as they tote me along. Beat the drum slowly and play the fife lonely. Play the death march as ye carry me along. Throw bunches of lilies all over my coffin. There goes a poor cowboy who knows he done wrong. That's serious, huh?
Yeah.
Maybe I shouldn't have played. That's really depressing.
No. There's catharsis.
Some catharsis?
Yeah, there's some catharsis. You want some catharsis on
some
the side?
Catharsis.
Yeah, you're right.
Let's see if this is the right one.
It's a great song, though.
It is. It's spooky.
They're all great. It's amazing how good these are.
I'm going to play my friend Doug had asked for a... Delmore Brothers song last week. This is definitely a Delmore Brothers song. Let's see here. Oh. This one is called Gonna Lay Down My Own Guitar. I see time is moving along. We're crunching. We play a quick version of this. The Problem. Problem. We definitely need the problem. There's a problem.
Yeah, I agree with you. It was wonderful. That was good. That cowboy song is great.
I'm gonna lay down my old guitar. Gonna lay down my old guitar. Oh, I wish I could tie it to my side and take it. There's no one to cry for me. There's no one to cry for me. I wandered so far away, don't you see? There's no one to cry for me. Gonna lay down my old guitar. Gonna lay down my old guitar. Oh, I wish I could tie it to my side. Take it along. Yodelay, 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 yodelay.
Song
for all that we need. All right, y'all, we got a couple more to hear, y'all, before we go away for this week. Once again, be kind to the tip bucket if you can. It's on the screen somewhere. It's also on this sheet of paper that we printed out. Low tech. High tech printer, low tech tape job. This one is a JJ Cale song that I've been playing lately. I think it seems fair and the right thing to do that, and also the migrant song, which I'm going to end up with. Thank y'all for listening. Here we go. Can't go wrong with JJ Cale. And Michael, if you're listening, I didn't get a chance to look at them words, but I'll do it this weekend. Seems like I got plenty of time. We ain't going nowhere anytime soon. Have you heard the news that's going round here? The man in charge, he's gotta go, 'cause he dances around the problem boy, and the problem is the man in charge, you know. Now the young know what I'm talking about. It's a con in the old man's game. The man in charge, he don't know what he's doing. He don't know the world has changed. Well, the power seems to be so far up. The man on the street, he ain't got a clue. Well, the high top cats running your life, they think the problem is me and you. What to do? Have you heard the news that's going round here? The problem is the man in charge of you. Well, the problem is the man in charge of you. Have you heard the news that's going around here? The man in charge has gotta go. Well, the man in charge has gotta go. Hey, the man in charge has gotta go. JJ Cale. That's a great song. Thank y'all for listening. We appreciate it. We're going to end up with a Woody Guthrie song that I've taken a real big liking to. We'll be back, I think, next Friday. I don't think the world's going to change between now and then.
Well, let's hope it doesn't. JC, you're so welcome. Enjoy the beach. Ed, out there in Montana, we're happy that the sad songs made you happy. That sounds good to me. That's a good trade-off. I think a Christmas show, Charles, is probably not a bad idea. I think maybe we need to look into that.
I have a Christmas CD.
That's right. You do have a Christmas CD.
I've done with my friend John Fole and Teresa Anderson. It's also available iTunes. It's called Peace Stories. I just swallowed a bug. Whoa.
I knew there was one flying around your head.
Well, it ain't there no more. Lord.
Well, you don't need to eat supper tonight.
I got my protein. Sad songs are often good. Thank y'all for listening. I was trying to dig up some more songs. I figured in my repertoire I'm up to about 700 songs. Thanks to all of you for listening. It's like it's been a hell of an experience.
Keeps us even keel.
It's fun to do. Send me your requests. Most of the time we keep our heads real low and try to stay safe. We wear our masks. I have around my neck right here, my little mask. Besides, if you're looking for interesting masks, I do recommend these, which they're ties.
Tracy Thompson from Kabuki Hats in New Orleans.
Kabuki Hat, I really dig them.
K-A-B-K-I. David might actually put her up on his Facebook page if you want to see the stuff she's got. She's even got matching hats and masks if you want to go completely over the top. So mostly we just want everybody to be here next week and be careful this week.
We're going to look for you.
Yeah.
Jeff, we missed you if you listen to it later. And as usual,
right.
I will put this on YouTube for those of you who like to share it with your friends or those that don't do Facebook. I know it's kind of weird to say that while I'm on Facebook, but you know, you get my drift. You can send it to your friends, the link and all that, and they'll get it. You can subscribe to me, so if you miss, it's okay. We're going to be here with another edition. I'll find some more songs I've never done before, which is quite exciting. And I'll do it on another guitar. I'll take out the old. This is the one that got destroyed. The TSA had a good time at this one. And I got it back. I was lucky. There was a nice hole from here to here. The cowling's fixed for me. So it's a great guitar. If you look on the inside, it looks like the inside of my mouth with all the bad fillings that I've had. It looks terrible on the inside.
That's a hell of a simile.
It sounds good on the outside. Anyway, thank y'all for listening. This is Pastures of Plenty. Mighty hard road that my poor hands have pulled, my poor feet have traveled a hot and dusty road. Out of your dust bowl and westward we rolled, and your deserts were hot and your mountains were cold. I slept on the ground in the light of your moon. On the edge of your city, you'll see us and them. We come with the dust, we go with the wind. Well, it's north up to Oregon to gather up your hops. Dig the beans from your ground, cut the grapes from your vine, to set on your table your light sparkling wine. Pastures of plenty from dry desert ground, from the Grand Coulee Dam where the waters run down. Every state in the Union us migrants have been, we'll work in this fight, we'll fight till we win. Hey. It's always we ramble that river and I, all along your green valley I'll work till I die. My land I'll defend with my life if it be, cause my pastures are plenty, must always be free. Cause my pastures are plenty, must always be free. Merci beaucoup, y'all. A bientôt. Next Friday, 5 o'clock, happy hour.
Absolutely. Bye, everybody.
Be safe.